Welcome back to TV5 News at 9. Joining us this morning, a real treat. Artist Egal Ozeri from the Flint Institute of Arts. Thank you so much for being here. How are you?
Very good. Thank you so much.
You are welcome. Today we are talking about your new exhibit, Brush with Reality. I love that title. So tell us, what can people expect from this exhibit, Egal?
It's a group of work that I've done in the last 20 years. The works included my works with women in the nature, that is my main subject. And the new series that I've done in the last 2 years, it's the New York scene. The New York scene that I done in New York, in Brooklyn and Queens, and all the boroughs in New York. The show was landed by many collectors, included Eileen Kaminsky, Wen Yex, Lou Mizell, myself, the collection of my family. We were able to put a major show of 60 works into the museum. The Flint Museum, it's a very special museum because if you can think about this area and all the history of that past area, and you can see a museum with such an incredible collection from classical to modern to contemporary, I think after the show that they done of the photorealism like 3 years ago that Louis Mizell curate, they react very well to my work, and that was how it started, the idea to build a one-man show of my work. And the opening night was a great reaction. A lot of people come. The people in Flint and the people in the Detroit, I have many collectors from this area. And the reaction was really nice, and a lot of warm regards, and people connect to the works and make you feel so good. You work on your body of work for so many years and you're alone in the studio, and then suddenly people come and react, and it's make you feel so good, like an artist.
Yeah, and you are incredibly talented. How did you get started as an artist?
Oh, I started when I was 7 years old. I had a neighbor that he was every Saturday take me to his home and give me books, encyclopedia, and he used to copy a lot of different animals, and I used to sit with him and do the same. So that was the first introduction to art or to paint, and it used to make me like breakfast. Wow. And then my father, when I was 10 years old, used to take me with his car to Jerusalem and to Jaffa and sit with me. He was very proud, and I was painting from the nature. I do drawing and I do watercolor. And I will never forget that moment that my father took me. Even he didn't understand anything in art, he just realized that I paint all the time and I draw all the time. And that's how I start in Israel.
That's amazing. So which artists do you consider your biggest inspirations?
Oh, right now, the artist that I love very much is Andrew White, of course, the American amazing artist. I remember that was a show in Philadelphia, and I went to see it in the museum, the modern art there, and I saw thousands of people waiting outside, and I was asking him, where you come from? And everybody said, from Arizona, from Los Angeles. Everybody come from all United States. And I was so amazed by that. And in the same week, they asked Robert Storr in the MoMA, why you should not bring this show to the MoMA? Because you have works of Andrew White. And he answered, and it was a strange answer. He said, I will never forget. He said, Andrew White is esoteric artist. Only him and his family could understand what he done. And how curator could say something about amazing artists that, yes, he paint in Pennsylvania somewhere, he paint people, he paint with love, and he was such a special, unique language that he create. And this helped me so much when I think that Andrew White in the American tradition is a major artist, and he influenced me how he used the small brush in tempera color on a wood or in canvas. And I feel that in somehow he died a couple of years ago, and somehow nobody continue his legacy or continue, and he influenced my work very, very much. I love his work, and he inspired me a lot. I deal with women in nature.
Yes.
And I take women to the nature, photograph them, and paint them.
Well, tell us a little bit about that. You've always been influenced by women. Can you elaborate on why that is, why you love to focus on women?
Yeah, because you always said, you know, they asked me, why women? I said, what is the most biggest subject in the art world since the Leonardo da Vinci, since Rubens, since all of this? Women. Women always was painted. They brought the beauty. I'm not afraid to deal with beauty. I think many artists today dealing with shocking, with political subject matter, with violent, with they want to shock the world, and I want to bring back the intimacy. And the beauty and the love today in the life that we live, women start to get back the power that they deserve, and I'm very proud of that. And in my works, they always women against nature, women that stand in front of nature and be powerful like the whole nature.
And your work is definitely powerful. It's amazing. It's mesmerizing. And we appreciate you bringing that to Mid-Michigan, to Flint. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
You are so welcome. You can find more information in the hot link section of WNEM.com.